Right now, in the UK, secondary schools are due back in full in September with no expectations of social distancing and very little guidance for risk assessment. I work in the worst affected borough of London, where huge numbers of our kids have lost family members. Over 50% of kids live in poverty. We have the highest levels of gang crime, radicalization, sex trafficking, child abuse, and neglect. And only around 5 to 10% of kids in classes have had access to internet for remote learning. Since we went into lockdown in March, many I haven't heard from at all. Social services and child protective services are already overwhelmed. I am worried for myself and my colleagues as we enter precarious working conditions. But mostly I worry for the kids and their community. We cannot go back to normal and many will be deeply traumatized. When I try to talk about how anxious I feel, nobody in my family or friendship group understands. They just tell me to stop worrying and enjoy my summer break. I will be in the Northwest and I just don't understand how this is supposed to work. I want to be back in school so badly, but I can't see how it will be safe to have the whole school in at once. I know the school I'm going to is doing everything in their power to make it as safe as possible. But the situation the government has put schools in is no win. How can they say that we need to wear masks in shops, which I completely support, but that it's safe for 30 kids to be in a room with no social distancing and no PPE? I'm sorry for what your school, students and community have gone through, or going through. You are a good teacher. Aw man, I love how conservatism and austerity have swept the globe. We're going to have another entire generation of children who grow up damaged from the avoidable trauma of poverty in the UK and USA. I'm an elementary teacher and this feels like one of those situations where there's just not a great answer. How effective the teaching will be. Copyright how parents will manage that arrangement alongside their jobs. 1. What happens if I contract COVID? Do I need to have 2 weeks of lessons prepared for a substitute at all times? Can there possibly be enough substitute teaching candidates out there to fill all the gaps left by COVID diagnoses or suspected COVID diagnoses? Or contact with COVIDY? Substitutes already do not make a living wage for their work. Or if they do, it's barely so. I can't imagine they're going to be more enthusiastic about going to schools under FIOs. 2. What happens if my significant other, also a teacher, at a different school, comes into direct when other sicknesses start popping up as winter nears? Will cold be presumed COVID until PED? 4. Our state mentioned that teachers should socially distance from students. How do 1. Rear any EU need? Worry about my ability to communicate effectively or an entire day through a mask? Considering the difficulties some of my students already had with listening, add a socially distanced element that's likely going to have some of my students extended all the way to paying arts. 6. Selfishly, I've wondered where my breaks and planning time would fit. There's been talks about eliminating specials, things like gym, R, library, etc., and keeping students in the same room all day, including lunchtime and perhaps recess. How do I get away from my own PIA 2.7.1 if we spit schedules? Some kids come on some days, some on others. How in the world will transportation work for those guys? A local district concluded that buses would have to make 8 runs to pick up kids in a socially distanced manner. BEE remens. Bathroom to themselves. Time out of every hour to clean or wipe down laptops, manipulatives, desks, etc. We already spend a lot of time on routines pre-COVID, so doubling down makes me wonder exactly how much time will be left to actually try to teach grandparents standing in as primary guardians. What happens if student contracts COVID at school and takes it home to their advanced age primary caretaker? Is our small community ed 10-1 if we go hybrid? Some home, some online. Who's in charge of managing each cistern? See, curating online content was a job in and of itself. So how could a teacher be expected to go through full school days and then prepare online options for every subject? And how do we I hate that we've been trained to believe that having breaks and prep time is selfish. It's not. It's essential to doing our job well. I have all the same feelings you shared here. It just struck me that you said it's selfish to think about breaks when other jobs have them protected by law. As a pregnant teacher, P breaks are really important to me. Hopefully, if we have to supervise and teach one group of students all day, someone will let me out for a pee break so I don't wet. This is the questions that should be answered. This is spot on. COVID is the new common cold. It spreads basically the same. If you catch the common cold from some person, you could also have caught COVID from them. Except COVID, it is more contagious. So once the common cold starts to spread, COVID will spread along. There likely are already more COVID cases than common cold cases right now because the common cold was also reduced by the social distancing that happened. So if you get what feels like the common cold, it's likely it's actually COVID. If you know from experience that there is always a flu common cold wave sometimes, like when the summer holidays end, expect a local COVID outbreak or no illness at all. So many of these complicated issues like the bus problem have never occurred to me. This really is on your win scenario. I've been put off school for a while and would have never even considered half the things on this list. Wow. Yeah, this is going to be rough. I love this response and I'd give you an award if I could. I feel like a lot of people that discuss this topic don't often consider most of these concerns you listed, but they are very valid and important things to consider. Thank you so much for addressing them and for everything that you do. Also, adding on to your first points, the testing for COVID isn't always accurate. False positives and false negatives are a thing. Even if everything is figured out and executed perfectly, which we're talking about kids here, there is no way, even if staff did everything right, that all the kids will. There's still great risk of slips through false test results. It's a small percent, but in such large, when lambda n equals BEAE. Thank you for taking the time to type this out. I don't have kids, so I've been watching everything unfold at a distance. I knew everything was a gigantic mess. Your points have helped me to organize everything in my head. All of these thoughts are super relatable and important. I work in a special education non-public school, and my school is currently deciding whether to come back to on-campus learning mid-August. You highlighted being able to teach effectively from 6 feet away, and there is just no way I can effectively teach and prompt my students from that distance. Some of them need hand guidance to complete tasks and activities. I can wear a mask and gloves throughout the whole day, but how effective will this really be? Some YATCTL equals LACL LOMUM DO RIAM LM LOOL OR MULMES EEEGCMAAT government is being ignorant about. They know school is essential, but they cut funding for the schools and expect the schools to figure it out. So are schools essential and non-essential at the same time? Are schools glorified daycares? I'm a parent where I have no childcare in the fall unless I send my child back to school. But it's not safe for him. He's 6. Right at that age where they pass colds back and forth like crazy. And he he needs OT, which is impossible with social distancing. I have very mixed feelings. I really miss my students and can't wait to see them. I know that online, CTA TLE MIA LM CS LIDO LO LW LO TL COL MAMI SL LA MU AMALI MAMU. Perfectly summed up right here. This is how parents of students are feeling as well. My S-year-old needs the social interaction and isn't getting it. That can't be replaced with online schooling, which, let's be honest, also isn't going to be as good because us parents can barely get them to eat dinner properly, let alone try to teach them. In the end, it's frustrating. We will probably be putting the kids in school whenever the schools deem it safe to open, but there's certainly apprehension. Notice no mention of their own safety. Like a true selfless educator, we're concerned for your health too. Mr. Jules, stay safe. Do you fear for your own health as well? I feel like you'd almost have to, maybe secondary to your concern about your students, but still agree with this for sure. I learned quickly last spring that I got in the teaching game to interact with students in person, not talk to a computer screen. But I live in a COVID hotspot state, so I just need to learn to adapt. Honestly, this captures my feelings. Spoken like a true teacher, putting the health of your kids and their families first, not one mention of your own health and safety, which is exactly why it's ludicrous to return under these circumstances.